Hello, Shauna. Hello, you guys. Hello. Give us a shout out. Hello. Hey, Tony. Some of the people are still sending messages in the VIP private group. I don't know if somebody can just... Those that are in the group, I can't read their messages now, so I hope they are not confused on where to go. So if somebody that's in the group can just read those messages, and if they're asking where am I, just to guide them here. Hi, Cindy. Give us a shout out. Hello. Hello, Marina. Marina. Okay, we're just gonna wait a few more moments for everybody to pop in, because there's quite a few of you already. So I'm just waiting for everybody else to pop in. Hey, Lisa. Lisa Haney. I was looking for your post in the accountability post on snake diet motivation. I can't find you. Hi, Laurie. Happy Friday to you too. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Well, it's nighttime here in Dubai. Hey, Shauna. Lisa Haney says, I posted it in July. No, you got to do a new post. My friend, a new post. If you want to be in this VIP group, you got to start all over. It's a new year, 2019, new accountability post. Tag my name as your coach starting now with new scale weights. So you got to delete that one. You don't delete it. You just do a new accountability post with me as your coach. So I was wondering where you were. Hi, Maria. You guys, we are on our round two of our 72-hour fasting routine. Give us a shout out, hello, once you've signed in. We're waiting for you guys. I think you've been waiting in the VIP group. Am I right? Hanging in there. I do the lives on the Facebook coaching group page, and I notify the VIP group in advance when I'm going live. And then I load the video up on YouTube for everybody else to watch. Give us a shout out. Hello. Hello, Angela. Shauna, I'm so ready to refeed. Gosh, girl. Gotta get that fasting going. But I know it's refeed time today. Hey, Tanya. Nice to see you. Yeah, Tanya. Lisa Haney says, my weight, my body weight hasn't changed since July. Lol. It doesn't matter, Lisa. It doesn't matter. I'm not interested in what it was in July. We got to start new foundation, new energy, new spirit, new vibe. Start a whole new one. Lisa, start a new one now. Post it today. New one, new photographs, new feeling. John Papa, say hello. Okay, Lisa. Tanya, thank you. Hope you're doing well. Tanya, I'm doing great, my friend. I'm doing great. Thank you. So great to chat to you guys. Sometimes I can be a bit like abrupt on the VIP group. No, sorry. But I just got to do my thing. Caroline. Hi, Micheline. So glad to be here. Jumping in on the next 72-hour fast. Yes, yes, wonderful. All right, you guys, let's get to it. Keep your questions on hold. just for a moment, because we will be doing questions and answers this evening. All right, I need to get to the coaching. All the questions are coming through here. All right, okay, let me focus here. We are now in our round two of our 72-hour fast. So the first, the group started last Sunday on day one, and we completed our first 72-hour fasting routine. It consisted of 2 days snake juice rolled into a 1 day soft dry fast into a small refeed. Not quite small, but a real proper refeed where the calories were between 500 and 580 calories. And then all we did then was redo another 72 the exact same. And it was our first refeed was Sunday, Monday was Tuesday. Then we started again on Wednesday with our second round of our 72s, which we are doing, completing now, which was Wednesday, was day one. Remember to put in your journals, day one, Wednesday. All right. Day two was Thursday. And now it's our refeed today, which is day three, which is a dry fast, soft dry fast, which is Friday. So we all got that. Hey, John, nice to see you here. Okay, so we've completed Wednesday was day one snake juice. Thursday was day two snake juice again. Friday is our soft dry fast, which is today. And we are going to be doing our second refeed, small refeed, at 7 p.m. tonight. So, are you all still going strong? Yes, you are. I'm sure you are. There's been a few detox symptoms coming through via the VIP group with a bit of an uncomfortable feeling with some of you guys. You got to understand that the symptoms are the real deal, okay? I don't know what you guys have been up to in the past with your foods and everything else, but this is what's coming out in body ache, back ache. Some of the ladies say it's like labor pain in the lower back. I know that feeling. When I did a 72-hour fast, my lower back was incredibly sore. And a bit of muscle ache as well. It's part of detoxing. Some people come up with spots on their face and their back. But the cramps, make sure, one of the detox symptoms, the muscle cramps, make sure that your salts are correct. Make sure the salts are correct, okay? And the detox symptoms will keep going, will keep coming out until the body starts to rebalance itself and starts to get into a good feeling, guys. All right, let me just see the questions here. So, understand you are going to get detox symptoms. This is all part of it. This is part of it, guys. We have to get rid of the fat. Detox symptoms, get rid of all the rubbish that's in the body. We want to reset our system, reset our metabolism, reset our guts, reset our head, our mind. The headaches go through. You're not allowed to take any tablets. There's no tablets to be taken while fasting. No tablets. And no coffee and tea during fasting. You guys, I hope none of you have been drinking that down, because then it's not a true fast. It's not real proper detox fasting. All right, so today we are on our day three. Soft dry fasting, which is only brushing teeth, washing hands, no water contact, no water intake either. And 6:30 p.m. today, this evening, you guys will be breaking your fast with your kidney cleansing shot, which is explained in my previous videos. Make sure you watch them for clear understanding. And what you need to remember is to weigh yourself before your refeed, before you break your fast at 6:30 with your kidney cleansing shot. You have to weigh yourself. Now, this is where the true understanding comes in. This is where you're going to learn how to fast with your refeeds and understand how it works. Before you do your refeed, the number that pops up when you do your weigh-in needs to be lower than your previous pre-scale weigh-in before your refeed last week. That number needs to be lower. Okay? That's the number that we need to follow. That's the number that we need to focus on. That needs to be lower before you can have your refeed. Now, if the numbers are still high, if your numbers have not dropped, you are carrying water, you're drinking, or you're drinking too much water, or you are stressing, or you are not getting enough sleep, or some of the ladies, you might have a menstrual cycle starting. But if you're not getting proper rest, proper sleep, your lifestyle is not highly stressed, the numbers must come down. Guys, I don't know if the color on this video is popping different colors the whole time. I hope I'm okay on your side. Okay, let's focus now. What's important right now is that things are going to start changing after our second refeed. So Saturday, we're going to start day one. But now everybody's asking me, what's our refeed? What's our refeed? It's the same. Your refeed is the same as last refeed. It's the same as your first refeed. It was beautiful fish, butter, your vegetables, and some cucumber and coconut water. Some people are asking me questions from the video of last week. What's the refeed? It just shows you guys are not, some of the people are not watching and listening correctly, or more listening correctly. But now, okay, I'm not going to focus on them. At the moment, you have to understand that the refeed is going to stay the same for this one. Our third round of our group coaching is going to change a bit. Okay. It's going to change. There's a few things I want to clarify. Let me just write it here. I want to pop it down on the piece of paper so I don't forget to talk to you guys about it. Quick, let me just do your... Okay, right. Let me answer some questions quickly. Let me go down here. Shauna Love says, I've lost 11 pounds so far. Girlfriend, that's fantastic. High five to you. 11 pounds so far. That is fantastic. Guys, we have been fasting for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, almost a full 6 days. Almost a full 6 days. And Shauna has lost 11 pounds. You should be all, you all should be losing a pound a day. A pound a day, which will be perfect. But do understand, it does change. It can slow down sometimes. In the beginning, it goes fast. Sometimes it slows down and you can lose half a pound a day. Okay? But the way we're going to accelerate things is by next week, we're going to start training. Next week, we incorporate our training, which accelerates the fat loss. I want to explain to you before I answer the following questions. Hello, Sandy. Great, nice to see you here. With myself, because I run a 24-hour fasting routine, I'm on 24 hours. I'm on maintenance. I maintain my scale weight. Now, when I eat my meal, then I weigh myself the next morning, my scale always just jumps up, maybe just under a pound every time. Nothing, never more than a pound. That's about 500 grams. It's like half a kilogram, 500 grams. Maybe it jumps up. Maybe. It depends on what I've eaten, okay? But by the time my next refeed, comes that evening, my scale is right down again. The scale, I weigh myself before I refeed, the scale is right down, sometimes lower than my weight the previous day. You see? It doesn't keep climbing up. When I incorporate, if I go training that day, which I train about 4 times a week, the scale, I've tested myself as well like this. When I say the scale has gone up the next morning after my refeed the night before, now I'm up now I'm up a pound, or yeah, a pound, which is half a kilogram, 500 grams. I go to the gym, I do a nice hour cardio and some weight training, just for example, easy going at the gym. The scale is right down again, even lower than what I was. So I can get a little sleeping in the afternoon, and I lose 300 grams when I wake up. When I wake up from my sleep, the scale is down. Do you understand the importance of sleep, making sure the body stays active, and your refeeds are just perfect? How stunning is that, you guys? You get proper sleep, even if you can get an hour sleep in the afternoon. I make sure I try and get an hour sleep in the afternoon, because I'm up at 4:30 in the morning for my clients that start at 5:30 in the morning. And I've got, my mornings are full up, but I incorporate my training. I try and make sure I get to bed a good time. But if I don't, I make sure I catch up on my sleep in the afternoon, and the scale drops right down. So importance of sleep, getting your training, your body moving active in the day, and your refeeds. Those are the three most important ingredients in keeping the body and mind balanced while fasting. Rest and recover, good refeeds, okay, and staying active. Right. Marina says, I need to make a post for your page. I'm going away and be back on Thursday. Can I jump in then? Yes, of course. Yes, of course. But it's not for my page. The accountability post needs to be sent to the Snake Diet Motivation page. Make sure that you read the description in the Snake Diet Coaching with Micheline Facebook group. The description is at the top. Let's see here. Tanya, yes, I'm feeling much better and not much hungry. Not much hunger. Yes, the symptoms are only temporary. Okay, let's see some questions. So Shana, well done on losing 11 pounds so far. Okay, Tanya, I'm only down 2 pounds since pre-refeed. Okay, so if your scale weight has slowed down, it's still dropping though. It's still dropping, okay? Sometimes the body's going to hold on. It's still dropping. But now, on round 3, this is where I change things up a bit. So, the scale weight has dropped. The scale weight before your refeed last time was down. You had your refeed, and now the scale weight has only come down 2 pounds. But that's fine, because we've only been fasting for 2 days. Today's our third day, which is our dry fast. So Tanya, tonight, at around about 6:30 when you do your weigh-in, the scale will be down. The scale will be down. Shana, I'm ready for workout. Great stuff. John, training. Love it. Perfect. Shana says, way to go. All right. Donna says, I wish I could sleep. Believe me. All right. Here's another little tip. If you're struggling to sleep at nighttime, what always helps me and has helped many of my other people I've been coaching is to take apple cider vinegar at nighttime. That was the option that you can take the apple cider vinegar shot at nighttime. That's number one. If you're struggling, if you're still not sleeping, you're under a lot of stress. Your mind is going tup, 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 going thinking crazy things, busy. I know I also get that sometimes, but you need to ensure you somehow work out a way to meditate. You got to read up on how to meditate. Meditation is vitally important to calm your mind, to stop everything and listen to what comes in, to calm the mind. All right. Shana says, is mineral water is okay with refeed? Mineral water, but that's what we're drinking though. It's a good source of mineral water with your salts, which equals your snake juice. Now, when you do your refeed, you got to just drink the mineral water without the snake juice ingredients. So it's plain, good source of mineral water. Mineral water can also be sparkling mineral water. Okay. Tanya says, yes, and my blood sugar is dropping and my blood ketone meter is going up. So your ketones, are you taking your, you all have to do your keto strips at 6:30 tonight. Make sure that's burning nice and strong. Donna says, my problem is the pain. Yeah. Nobody says fasting is going to be a walk in the park. We have to be tough. The pain is incredibly painful. Or everybody's symptoms are really, really different from everybody's. But majority of people also experience the same symptoms. The muscle pain. The muscle cramps. It's all part of detoxing. And that's, I know, that's what's keeping you awake at nighttime. Okay, so the muscle cramps from the detox or the muscle pain or the body's uncomfortable is keeping you awake at nighttime. You got to just grind it through. All right, Tanya, your ketone strips were high. You've only been fasting for 2 days. Two, 3 days. Well, today would be the third day, correct? Ketone strips are almost... Okay, but now we're going to do a refeed now. So what I'm trying to say is that even if you just drop 2 pounds, but it's fantastic. It's 2 pounds in 2 days. You still... And you wanted it to be higher, your ketone strips are like sky high. That means you're burning fat for energy. You're burning the fat. And now you're ready for your refeed. Tracy says, hi Micheline, feeling strong and in control. So excited about my progress. Thank you so much. I couldn't do this without your coaching. Thank you, Tracy. That's very kind of you. Great message. You're doing well. You're doing fantastic. I'm glad I could help so many. I can help so many people. And that's fantastic. That's fantastic. All right. All right, you guys. So far, everybody's going okay. Everybody's doing great. Now, we have to focus on the next part. I am going to be needing, this is where the exciting part starts. Next week, I want you to get, Saturday is going to be day one. Sunday is going to be day two. Monday is going to be day three. All right, we are doing a 72 again. Our round three is going to be another 72. But now this is where it changes. Write it down. Get your journal. Write this down. Make your notes now. Make your notes now. I'm going to come back to questions in a moment. Okay, so Saturday, day one, is going to be a dry fast. So Friday night, which is today, is your refeed. Half an hour eating window only. Exactly the same as last time. Saturday will be day one. Do not weigh yourself after your refeed. Remember that. That's just a reminder. Do not weigh yourself after you've eaten tonight. Do not weigh yourself after you've eaten tonight. You're only going to weigh yourself tomorrow morning, which will be day one, Saturday. The scale would have jumped up a bit, but it needs to drop down now. On Saturday, you're going to be doing a dry fast. Saturday, dry fast. You will have your apple cider vinegar anyways on Saturday morning. I incorporate that. That's where it'll be the last part of your dry fast. You're going to dry fast all the way through to Sunday. Sunday will be day two. Sunday will be day two, which will be snake juice. Sunday morning, you take your apple cider vinegar shot. You have snake juice, 1 liter of snake juice throughout the day. And your dry fasting starts again Saturday night. Between 7 and 8 p.m., you're going to stop drinking your snake juice and you're going to dry fast, soft dry fast, right through until Monday. Right through until Monday. Dry fast until your 6:30 Monday evening. Do your scale weight, check those numbers, make sure it's lower than this evening's scale weight number. Break the dry fast on Monday at 6:30 with a kidney cleansing shot. And then your refeed, which will be slightly different. Maybe. I have to first see something. I'm going to check something with you guys first. So do you all understand round three? 72 fasting, which is going to start on Saturday. Saturday day one will be your dry fast. Sunday day two will be your snake juice. Monday day three will be your dry fasting. Do you see the change that I've made? And then your refeed on Monday night. Now, make sure the scale weight numbers are dropping before your refeeds. You have to weigh yourself before your refeeds. Do not weigh yourself after you've eaten. You only weigh yourself the very next morning. I am going to ask every single one of you that is part of my VIP coaching group. There's 20 of you that I'm privately coaching in the group, on the VIP group. You all have to send me via the VIP group only your scale weight picture of when you started last week Sunday to You have to send me your skull wake picture on Monday 6:30. On Monday 6:30. What will be the date on Monday? Monday 6:30. I will message this to the group after this video. So, on Monday at 6:30, you need to take a picture of your skull weight. And I want you to put it on two picture, starting with the start weight and your skull weight on Monday. So Sunday's skull weight needs to be next to next Monday's skull weight. Do you understand that? I'm going to make a little note here. And then I want you to send me your pictures as well. The date from Sunday to the date on Monday. I will send this via the VIP group as well. Those who are not part of the VIP group, just do this as well at home. Those that are following me and following this routine, do it at home. It's important for you to track your progress and track your journal. You keep the photograph of your skull weight when you started last Sunday, 6 days ago. Then you have to, 9 days later, yeah, it will be 9 days later, you'll be taking your photographs and comparing it to your start photographs. And you send them to me via the VIP private messenger group, and then we'll be doing another accountability post into the snake diet motivation. So this week coming, the next 3 days, it's going to be grinding time. It's going to be go, 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 go time. Things are changing up big time now. Things are changing. Things are getting stronger and better. All right. If you're all understanding, so let me just answer the questions here. Tanya, okay, the reason I brought that up, because you said we need to be 4 to 6 pounds lower before next refeed. It's an encouraging number to reach. If you're training, you can get those numbers. If you're training, you can get those numbers, which we will be getting, which we will be incorporating next week. So focus, everybody, focus on a pound a day is more than enough. It's more than enough. A pound a day. Once you start incorporating training, you can lose a pound and a half a day. So if you're doing, if we're fasting on 72s, it's 3 days. Work on 3 pounds a day. That's perfect. Some of you are losing much more. But the average would be a pound a day, which is fine. If it slows down and you're not eating, don't panic. Don't panic. Trust the process. Because the body sometimes becomes really stubborn, you know, and don't want to move. Don't want to move. But it doesn't mean it's not burning fat, you guys. It does not mean you're not burning fat. Please understand that. If you have to start taking your measurements around your waist and your hips, you can start doing that by next. You can start doing that tomorrow. You take your measurements around your waist where the narrowest part is. The narrowest part. That's where you do the measurement. Not the. It needs to go around the belly button, okay? And your hips. Around the middle of your hips, around your buttocks, the middle, okay? And you track that. If those numbers are dropping as well, but say the scale weight numbers are not dropping, you check with the measurements, your measuring tape, those numbers will be dropping. Okay, not all good, Tanya, I understand. You're doing perfectly fine, perfectly fine. Shana, so when do we do pictures again? Shana, the pictures will be taken on Monday. What's the date on Monday, you guys? I don't have a calendar in front of me. Dawn, should I refeed? I was not planning to. Are you following our routine, Dawn? I'm sure you are. You joined us on the second round of fasting. If you've been fasting for 72 hours, then yes, you stay with us on track. Stay with us on track. Exactly the same. If you started your fasting 3 days ago, correct? Yes. And your scale weight numbers are dropping. If your scale weight has dropped, yes. Shana, don't forget kidney shots. Absolutely, kidney shot tonight at 6:30. Cindy, do we start at round 3 as first attempts? You can, but I would rather suggest you start at... You guys, it's your choice. If you're not part of the VIP group, it's up to you. If you're not part of my VIP group, Cindy Brooks, are you in our... I'm not too sure, you guys. I don't have the list of all the people that's in the VIP group. If you're in our VIP group and you've just joined the VIP group, follow along. Follow along. We're still on 72 hours. All right? You guys can do 2 snake juice, day 1 and 2, and a rollover into a dry fast. Or you can do, now that we've started round 3, dry fast, snake juice, dry fast, roll into refeed. Up to you. You will still be fine on both, okay? Okay, thank you, Ashley. So Monday will be the 21st. That on the 21st of January, that is where you're going to take your photographs, your 3 pictures, and then also you're going to put in one photograph your starting weight and your weight, your scale weight before your refeed on Monday. You're going to jot that down and put the picture next to it. Only for those that have been fasting since Sunday, last week Sunday. So that will be 9 days into your fasting routine. Those that have just started with me now, I've added a few of you in. You do not need to send me any pictures. I want you to start your 72 hours now with us. Tanya, so scale weight pics and pics of us. Yes! You send it to the VIP private group. It's only for our eyes at the moment. And then we're going to be taking it from there. Maria, I just wrote my scale weight down for last Sunday. I don't understand. I just wrote my scale weight down for last Sunday. You should be writing your scale weight down every single day, morning and night. Morning and night, every day. Or am I not understanding what you've said? Let me know, pop another message if I'm not getting it. Tanya, okay, thank you for that clarification. You're welcome. John, I love to do weight training. I took time off when I first started fasting on Sunday. When would be good time to reintroduce the weightlifting? Well, when you feel good, John. When you're feeling good. Okay, so those who are following a fasting routine and following the YouTube channel with the fasting routines, you guys, you can start training whenever you feel that you feel strong. If you're feeling strong, you can start training. I love doing weight training at time off. Yeah, of course. So when you start your fasting, you have to take time off. Because when you take time off, you're able just to get into your own head, start to build up the confidence, start to build up the understanding on how the body's feeling. and understand or trust your feeling, and then you can start incorporating after your first 72 hours of fasting. You start incorporating your training again, and take it slowly, and make sure you take your snake juice with you when you train. Don't be like me. I train dry fasted. So that's me, because I do 24 hours. You guys don't do 24 hours. So take your snake juice with you when you are training. Highly important, okay? Okay. Caroline, I will start with 72 hours snake juice first. Okay, Caroline, make sure it's 2 day snake juice. Roll over into your 3rd day soft, dry fast, okay? So only 48 hours snake juice, Caroline. Or 48, 40, I just answered it now. Okay, 48 snake juice, 24 dry, correct. Make sure, Caroline, make sure that you watch all the videos that I've sent, and you understand even better. Okay, Dorna says, yes, the reason that I ask if I should refeed is because the scale weight only was down 0.2, and you stated it had to be down 4 pounds. I'm with you, just confused. Okay, all good, all good. So, if you're fasting for 72 hours, say you're fasting for 3 days, if the scale weight is down 3 pounds, great. The scale weight is down 2.5 pounds. Still good. The scale weight needs to be dropping down. I wanted to be much stronger. I wanted to be 3 pounds above. So when you weigh yourself at 6:30 on your 3rd day, scale weight must have dropped 3 pounds. Okay, but still refeed. You cannot refeed if the scale weight has only dropped a pound. No, 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 no. The body still needs to strengthen some more. Okay, John, perfect. All right. I will always encourage training as long as you're feeling confident and you're feeling, let's do this. Ready, you ready? Take the snake juice with you. Tanya says, what should we be doing for training? That I'll be bringing in next week, guys. Next week. I'm not going to discuss training now. So I want you to finish your refeed now, tonight. Tomorrow, Saturday, is your dry fast, day one. And I'll be doing some live coaching then, and we'll be starting talking about training and getting our booties moving. Maria says, I am writing it down daily. Okay, but I just didn't take pictures of the scale. Well then, take a picture of what you wrote down. Take a picture of what you wrote down then, because it's just for the VIP group. But best to take a picture of the scale weight, okay, from now onwards. And if you've written it nicely in your journal, take a picture of that. Okay, Caroline, yes, catching up. Okay, perfect, Caroline. Jennifer, welcome, Jennifer. She says, I'm just starting today with you, but past have been doing it by myself, but often fall off after a few days. I'm terrified to get kicked out. Well, make sure you're not getting kicked out, okay? Because if you mess up, you're going to get kicked out. All right, Jennifer, it's time to grind. It's time to get yourself sorted. Jennifer started with us today, you guys. And now you're not doing it alone, Jennifer. There's no excuses. You are with a strong team. And we're all going to be by your side. But obviously, if you decide to make a choice of cheating, or if you decide to make a choice of the wrong choices, unfortunately, that's when I'm going to boot you out the team. But we're not going to, because you're going to be fantastic, correct? You're going to stay fantastic. You're going to do this. It's only 72 hours. And you'll build confidence. And you're going to build confidence within yourself of knowing what to do. So you don't have to be, don't focus on what can go wrong. You focus on celebrating being in this VIP team. Celebrate being with such powerful, energized people that all want to succeed. Okay? Only start focusing on that and celebrating this energy that is around you. So, you're going to be fine. You're not going to fail with this. You can't. You can't. Nice, Tanya. Definitely. Jennifer, you can push through it. You've got this. Right. It says, yeah, I don't know if I'm answering it. If Tanya, are you asking me or are you applying to Jennifer? Can we go walking now? Okay. You guys, next week you can incorporate your walking, but I'm going to be discussing that next week. You see what happens, that you guys are starting to feel strong now and you're starting to get, let's get going, let's get going. Your first 72 hours are done and dusted. Second 72 hours are almost done and dusted. Now you guys are wanting to get moving. You see how we work it. Now next week's like Saturday onwards, now you guys must incorporate walking. Yes, Tanya, we can incorporate your walking after your refeed. Saturday, I don't suggest when you dry fast. When you're dry fasting, do not exercise. So, let's book it in. Sunday, you're all going to go for 45 minutes to an hour walk. Sunday will be your day of incorporating your cardio. Note that down. Write it down. Sunday is your Snake Tuesday. Incorporate your cardio. John, if you're not dry fasting and you're doing Snake Juice, you can go train. Okay. Yes, Micheline. Tanya says, yes, Micheline, that's exactly what's going on. Okay. All right. Perfect. Everybody, today is Friday, refeed day, refeed night, evening coming up soon. I hope you're feeling positive, more positive than when you started, that you can actually give you guys a high five by yourself for completing almost done 6 days together. 6 days together. So just remember now, Monday will be photograph time. And keep to the same refeed. Alright, if you have any other questions, pop them in now. I'm going to be ending the live in a few moments. And there's a few things that I wanted to just pop in. If you have... No, I'm going to post this rather. Let me just see here. Yeah, no, that's all fine. Okay, I'll put a post together. Other questions here? John, got it. Don't lift while dry fasting. Well done. Great. Marcel! Hello! I'm joining in. February. Perfect. I'm going to be so excited. Now, Marcel is a good friend of mine way back in South Africa, Cape Town days. And it's so wonderful to see one of my homies on live chat here with me. That's wonderful. Marcel, I'm so excited for you to get started. You need to lose 10 kilograms. That's easy. That's easy. I'm going to show you. And it's going to be in the healthiest manner ever. No matter what anybody else says. No matter what. I've been battered so with some of the people in South Africa. Gosh. I can't wait. Marcel says she can't wait. You guys, I can't wait for Marcel to jump in. She's an awesome woman. She's very positive. She is been in the fitness industry as well. She's knows me since my dancing days, back when I was a teeny bopper. And she's just awesome. Once she joins our group, you guys are going to be hyped up as well. She's a brilliant, brilliant woman. Okay. All right, everybody. Last questions coming through. I'm also going to be doing a live, public live. So it won't be a coaching VIP live. I'm just going to be doing a public live. I will let you guys know as well, just to promote what we're doing and how awesome you guys are doing. Okay, so I'll let you know when I'll do that as well. You please stay strong, stay focused. I can't wait for everybody. There's a want to be okay. I can't wait for everybody's success. And can you just imagine? Can you imagine we're all posting the success stories and how our lives are changing for the better? I can't wait. You guys will keep that journal beautiful and strong next to you. And I can't wait for everybody's success. Okay. Now, enjoy your refeed this evening. Remember, it's the fish and all that jazz. You know what it is. If you've written it down last week as well. Don't overindulge, please. 30 minutes eating window. If you can't finish everything, leave it. But it doesn't mean that you have to come back afterwards. Once you finish eating, you've finished eating. You can have sparkling mineral water with your food. Make sure you drink your coconut water first. Tanya says, thanks for giving your time and doing this for us. You are so welcome. You're so welcome, Tanya. You're an awesome woman. I do this because I love this and I want success for you guys. I know the feeling. I mean, my family, there's a lot of obese people in my family, and I know what they're going through as well. Many tears back in the past, back in the day when I was still amongst them. But now things have changed. Okay, so stay strong, and I'm looking forward to those wonderful, wonderful success stories. Jennifer says, thank you for doing this. Any way to pay you for your time? Give me your success stories. Show me that you are making the best out of your lives, making the best out of your health. That's what I want. I want you guys to succeed. Truly from my heart, I want you guys to succeed. Truly, truly, truly. Your success is a great reward for me. Maria, thank you so much. Thank you, guys. Okay, stay strong and look forward to us getting training. Lisa, I'm down 5 pounds. Lisa, great. Let me see those photographs. All right, you guys, I love you all so much. Stay strong, and I'll catch you on VIP. Ciao.